Hi, my name is Peter Kleinhens. I'm an interpretive writer with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. And today, I'm going to show you how to set up a brand new project in iNaturalist. The first step to creating a project is to set up an iNaturalist account. So if you haven't done that already, feel free to log into floridanaturetrackers.com and follow our instructional video, or simply go to iNaturalist and follow the prompts there to set up an account. The first thing you're going to do to set up a project is actually to click on Places. Once I click on Places, I'm going to scroll down and go to Add a New Place. There, I'm going to click Manually Create a New Place, give my place a name, in my case, Peter K. Yard, and then I'm going to zoom in on the map to wherever my yard happens to be. For me, that's Tallahassee, Florida. This isn't my actual address, but I'm going to say that it is. And I'm going to click on Draw a Polygon, and let's say that this is my house. I don't know whose house this is, but I'll pretend it's mine. I'm going to overestimate the boundaries of my yard and go street to street. I'm going to close this polygon, and then once I closed it, I'm going to click on the first point, and that sets it up. I'm going to save that place, and I now have my own backyard place. Once I've set up my place, I'm going to go to Projects, and then I'm going to go to Start a New Project. I'm going to give my project a title, again, Peter K. Yard. I can write in a description, I can write in terms if I so choose, and if I'd like to have a nice cover photo, I just need to edit a photo of my backyard to 950 pixels wide by 400 pixels tall. I then scroll down and I'm going to type in my place I created. Again, that was Peter K. Yard. In your case, it would be your name and your yard. So I click on that, and then I go to Show Place Boundary on Map, and my yard should show up. In this case, it hasn't quite loaded. There it goes. The next and final step is going to be to set my observation rules. The first rule I'm going to set is that the observations must be observed in a place, in this case, Peter K. Yard. And I'm going to hit Create. There's two more observation rules, and I'm going to go to Edit Project, scroll down to Observation Rules, and add one more rule, which is must be verifiable, which means there must be a photo or sound to support my observation, and click Save, Proceed. And then the final rule is going to be that the observations must be wild or naturalized. So I'm going to set that and click Save. And now my backyard project is created. The final option you have is to join our Backyards of Florida project, one of our Florida Nature Trackers projects. You can go into Project and do Search Projects and type in Backyards of Florida. Here it is. And once you get there, you can go down here, check it out, and if you're interested, you can join the project. And once you join the project, you can add your observations to this project as well and help us document the life found in your own backyard. For more information on the Backyards and Beyond initiative, Florida Nature Trackers, or iNaturalist, shoot an email to floridanaturetrackers@myfwc.com. Thanks for watching and happy exploring.